see, we wanna see, we wanna see Jesus lifted high. We wanna see, we wanna see, we wanna see Jesus lifted high. We wanna see Jesus lifted high, a banner that flies across this land, that all men might see the truth and know He is the way to heaven. We wanna see Jesus lifted high, a banner that flies across this land, that all men might see the truth and know He is the way to heaven. We wanna see. We wanna see Jesus lifted high. We wanna see, we wanna see, we wanna see Jesus lifted high. Step by step we're moving forward, little by little taking ground. Every prayer a powerful weapon, strongholds come tumbling down and down and down. We wanna see, we wanna see Jesus lifted high. We wanna see, we wanna see, we wanna see Jesus lifted high. We wanna see, we're gonna see, we're gonna see Jesus lifted high. We're gonna see, we're gonna see, we're gonna see Jesus lifted. We wanna see. We wanna see, we wanna see Jesus lifted high. We wanna see, we wanna see, we wanna see Jesus lifted high. We wanna see, we're gonna see, we're gonna see Jesus lifted high. We're gonna see, we're gonna see, we're gonna see Jesus lifted high.
Age to age, he stands. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. It's good to be here tonight, and I'm also excited that you have chosen to join with us for another wonderful service in the presence of God. We are the Porter's House Christian Fellowship Church at number 94B Adeni Joseph Avenue here in Ikeja. We meet for our church services every Sunday morning at 10 o'clock, every Sunday evening at 6 p.m., and also on Wednesday for our midweek service at 6:30 p.m. You can also join us for our daily devotional from Monday to Friday on WhatsApp, our weekly prayer meetings on Zoom every Friday, and also our regular services on our YouTube channel. Tonight, I am believing God that He will minister to the heart of His children. So I want you to join with me as we turn our Bibles to the book of 1 Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 9. 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 9. And while you are at 1 Corinthians 16, verse 9, I also wanted to turn to Proverbs chapter 14, verse 12. Proverbs chapter 14, verse 12. So I'm going to read first of all the 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 9. For a great and effective door has been opened to me, and there are many adversaries. For a great and effective door has been opened to me, and there are many adversaries. The Proverbs chapter 14, verse 12. So there is a way that seems right to a man, but the end of it is destruction. There is a way that seems right to a man, but the end of it is destruction. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, I come before you this evening. Lord, I pray that you will allow the Holy Spirit to minister to our hearts. Lord, I pray even tonight you'll be glorified as we become not just hearers of your word, but doers, O God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. A group of students had just graduated from Assays Academy, and they were being addressed by a professor on their last day in school. The professor said to them, there are so many opportunities out there for you that you need to take advantage of. All you need to do is to get the right opportunity and make the best use of it. Then one of the students asked, sir, how do I know an opportunity is the right opportunity for me? The professor replied, when you jump at every opportunity that comes your way, you will get the right opportunity. When you jump at every opportunity that comes your way, you will get the right opportunity. When I read this story a few years ago, it sounds a little bit of a common sense to these graduating students, but when you look at it from another angle, it is not every opportunity that comes your way that becomes the right opportunity. Because there are some open doors that will present themselves as great, but they end up becoming a disaster. And also there are some opportunities that are far from being great, but they end up becoming the best of the best of one's opportunity in life. And the question is, and sometimes, you know, we can get to a place where we are in between the two and we are thinking, you know what, I don't want to miss the open doors that I have before me because I'm not sure if they're from God. And at the same time also, we want to take advantage of every opportunity that comes our way, believing and assuming it's from God. So tonight I'm going to share with you three things that will help us discern if an opportunity is really a open door from God or not. So I'm going to be ministering a message I've entitled, Open Door from God or Not from God. Open door from God or not from God. And the first thing I want to look at is contradiction. Contradiction. As believers in the kingdom of God, we will be faced with a lot of opportunities in life. that will require critical decision making. And these opportunities can be very juicy and sometimes even promising, such as getting married, securing a job, doing business, pastoring a church, raising our kids, and many more opportunities like that. And the first thing that we need to wisely consider when we are faced with these opportunities of life, or when we are faced with this open door, is to ensure that this opportunity or this open door does not contradict the word of God. Because God will not lead us to an opportunity that clearly goes against his word. In one of the miracles that Jesus performed in the Bible, he healed a man that was possessed by demonic spirits. And at the sight of this miracle, the Bible made us to understand everyone was excited except the Pharisees. They were mad at Jesus. They were mad with Jesus. They were mad at his miracle. They said he used the power of the rulers of demons to cast out demons. And the Bible says in Matthew chapter 12, verse 25, Jesus knew their thoughts and said to them, every kingdom divided against itself is brought to destruction, and every city or house divided against itself will not stand. Verse 26, if Satan casts out Satan, he is divided against himself. But then how will his kingdom stand? And if I cast out demons by Beelzebul, by whom do your son cast them out? Therefore they shall be your judges. But if I cast out demons by the Spirit of God, then the kingdom of God has come upon you. From this scripture, we could see Jesus challenged the thoughts of the Pharisees. He corrected their wrong reasonings. And he also made it clear that Satan will not go against himself. Satan will not cast out himself. And if the kingdom of the devil will not want to go against itself, how much more the kingdom of God, which is greater? You know, it saddens my heart sometimes, and not just sometimes, a lot of time, when people read the word of God and they come up with a conclusion that the word of God contradicts itself. The word of God, which was written under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, does not go against itself. Because God is not an author of confusion. If you read the word of God and you really want to understand it, you need the help of the Holy Spirit to be able to help you to do that. In Isaiah chapter 55, verse 11, it says, in the same way, my words leave my mouth and they do not come back without result. My words make the things happen that I want to happen. They succeed in doing what I send them to do. Apart from the fact that God is telling us from Isaiah 55 verse 11 that his word would not return back to him empty, the scripture is also making us to understand that the word of God will not conflict each other. And this is because if the word of God goes against each other, how is it going to accomplish what God intended it to do? God's word will go out and it will accomplish the intent of God because it doesn't conflict each other. So when you are faced with an open door, when we have before us open doors and opportunities, which I believe some of us have already started experiencing. And if you have not started experiencing open doors, I pray that God, amen, will open door for you that no man will be able to shut. Can somebody say amen? What I'm trying to say tonight is that when we come face to face with opportunities in life, and we're not really sure whether it's from God or not from God, one of the first steps to know it's from God or it's not from God is that such open door and such opportunity should not contradict the word of God. Because God will not give you opportunities. God will not give us open door that will go against His word. A lot of open doors sometimes are mere temptations. And when something is a temptation, it's either you resist it and you flee. I want to look secondly at confirmation. Confirmation. Remember I said earlier that not every open door or every opportunity that comes your way is from God. Some open doors are just temptations in disguise. And that is why the second thing that we need to deeply consider to know whether an opportunity is from God or not is to confirm those opportunities. Confirm the open door before you. This is because, see, anyone can easily put scriptures together to justify the open doors before them. And they can tell the old one, you know what, my open doors or the opportunities I have before me aligns with the word of God. The word of God that they are aligning those opportunities with are something they've put together by themselves just to justify the opportunity that they're about to enter into. And at the end of the day, they end up deceiving themselves and not God. Because the Bible says in Galatians chapter 6 verse 7, do not be deceived. God cannot be mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he will also reap. There are three ways in which the open door that you have before you, or the opportunity that we have before us, can be confirmed if it's from God or it's not from God. The first thing we need to do is to confirm that, is to commit such open doors into the hands of God. You have an opportunity before you, and you're not sure, maybe this is God giving me this opportunity, or maybe the opportunity is just something else. To confirm that opportunity, we need to commit it into the hands of God. If you really want God, if you really want to know that the open door that you have is from God, then get God involved. Ask Him. See, God will always reveal His mind to His people concerning the opportunity and the open door that He has placed before them. You know, Solomon said in his wisdom in Proverbs chapter 16, verse 33, he said, the lot is cast into the lap, but the whole outcome is of the Lord. And I like the way another Bible version puts it. It says, we make our own decisions. We make our own decisions, but the Lord alone determines what happens. We make our own decisions, but the Lord alone determines what happens. That you really want to know if this is from God, then commit it to the hands of God, and God will definitely speak to you and say, you know what, this is from me. He will let us know. The second way of confirming if the open door is from God or not is to seek counsel. To seek counsel. And this is not just anyhow counsel, but a godly counsel. You know, for every child of God, God has placed at our disposal godly counsel that we can take advantage of to help us discern if this is from God or this is not from God. You know, one of the things I always thank God for good friends that could give you advice when you want to make decisions. Thank God for godly friends, right? That will give you advice when you want to make decisions. Thank God for parents also who are deeply rooted in the word of God that can guide you in decision making. And thank God even for pastors who are spiritual father, your pastor, my pastor, who are our spiritual father, who can help us discern this is from God or that is from God. The third way to know if an open door, to confirm if an open door is from God or not, is to check for evidence. See, there will always be a pointer. Okay, there will always be a pointer concerning if this open door or this opportunity is from God. There will always be a pointer. I remember when I was about to pioneer my first church, to pioneer for a church. We were initially launched to Magodo, and my wife and I went to Magodo. We could not get a place that we could use for the church building. It was a little bit tough just penetrating and getting through to the people. But I was able to see a building for the church around Ojota. Very nice place. And I felt, you know what, this is the place. But the agent was pressurizing us just to pay. In actual fact, he told me that, you know what, one of the musicians in Lagos is about to take the place as a warehouse for his musical instruments. And I'm like, you know what, let me seal this deal. I can't wait any longer. I just want to go out and start telling people about Jesus and winning souls to the kingdom of God. But eventually we lost that place. And as I was going back to church that day, I was going back to church, and something was in my mind was telling me, you know what? What about the place that you grew up? What about that place? Why don't you go there and start a church? And as I was thinking about that in my mind, God also began to remind me, do you know that there was a point when you were a Bible study leader, you actually had a satellite church in that area, and it was fruitful. As I was thinking through the radar and processing that, my pastor turned to me and said, you know what, Jimmy, what about Pearl? Why don't we try Pearl since we've lost Ojota? And straight away I said to pastor, I said, Pastor Glenn, that's exactly what I'm thinking. Because here is an open door before me, but God begins to bring a pointer, and to crown it all, you know, one time I was on the bike and I witnessed to the Okada guy. I preached to the Okada man, and this Okada man got saved, and he witnessed to someone else, and the person he witnessed to happened to be someone in peril. And the guy eventually became one of my disciples. So the truth is that when there's an open door before you and it's from God, there will always be a pointer. You know, Jesus, Paul said in 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 1, he says, this is the third time I'm coming to you. In the mouth of two or three witnesses shall every word be established. This scripture was also used by Jesus Christ, and even during the time of Moses, to bear witness concerning the wrong of other people and to give a testimony to what had happened so that the truth can be established. See, I am of the opinion, and I strongly believe this is also valid when it comes to determining if the open door before you is from God or not, that with two or three pointers, with two or three witnesses, You can be able to establish, oh, this is from God or this is not from God. That through the scriptures in the Bible, prayers, godly advice, discernment, and situations, not compromising situations that constantly present itself to you and I, you'll be able to tell that this open door and its confirmation are truly from God or they're not from God. I want to close tonight by looking at the third point, the connection. The connection. So one of the things that should give us joy as Christians is that God has said, he has set before us an open door that no man can shut. That God is saying, when he opens the door for you, no one can close the door. And when it closes the door, no one can open the door. So when it comes to whether an open door is from God or not, or an opportunity is from God or not, the issue of connection needs to be considered too. Because you have a relationship with God, and God has a relationship with you, God is not going to open doors that will take us away from Him. Because Jeremiah 31 verse 3 says, the Lord appeared to us in the past, said, I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have drawn you with unfailing kindness. God, out of His love for you and I, will not expose us to opportunities or open doors that will drag us away from Him. He's not going to give us that kind of door that will make us say, you know what, we no longer need Him. Now we can do things on our own. So no matter the open doors and opportunities that you have before you, you still need God. No matter the open doors and opportunities that I have before me, I still need God. God will not let you enter in through a door that will take Him away from you. In the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 20, 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 35, the Bible talks about King Jehoshaphat. It says, later, Jehoshaphat, the king of Judah, made alliance with Ahaziah, the king of Israel, whose ways were wicked. He agreed with him to construct a fleet of trading ships. After these were built in Ezon Geber, Eleazar, the son of Dodavahu of Maresh, prophesied against Jehoshaphat, saying, because you've made alliance with Ahaziah, the Lord will destroy what you have made. The ships were wrecked, and they were not able to set sail to trade. Here in this story, King Jehoshaphat, who happens to be a righteous king, a king like his forefather, David, whose heart is right with God, decided to join alliance with Ahaziah, the son of King Ahab. To Jehoshaphat, we can do business together. There is an opportunity for us. Bible says they constructed a fleet of trading ship that they can use for buying and selling. So to Jehoshaphat, I mean, it's a great opportunity for me to expand my coast, to expand my kingdom, my wealth. But God sees that as an opportunity that will take Jehoshaphat away from God. And what happened in our text, the Bible says, God destroyed their ship. And this is to tell you, and to tell everyone, that you know what? If there is an open door before you, no matter how fantastic that open door may be, if it's going to take you away from God, then it's not from God. When we have opportunity that will disconnect us from God, because God wants His children to be more closer to Him. And He will constantly open doors for you and I. He will constantly bring before us opportunities that will draw us more closer to Him. See, it's sad how many people look at the opportunity before them without considering the fact that is this from God or is this something else? And they plug themselves into that open door, and they ended up in disaster. Solomon said in our text, there is a way that seems right before man. It seems good. It seems excellent. It's like, this is what I've been waiting for. Now it's before me. But is it from God? And many lives of believers have been destroyed, because they fail to consider the fact that, you know what? It's not every opportunity, it's not every open door that comes my way that is from God. If I have a fantastic opportunity before me, great one before me, I've got to consider, does it contradict the word of God? What are the things that confirm that this is from God? Have I been able to get a godly counsel? Have I prayed about it? What are the pointers around me? And above all, does this opportunity take me away from God, or does it draw me closer to God? See, God is not against you and I taking advantage of opportunities in life. And I'm not against people taking advantage of opportunities in life. I have seen opportunities and I've taken advantage of it, and it has blessed my life. Taking your opportunity and open door to God is very critical. No matter how wonderful it may be, we've got to take it to God. Confirm through the word of God, godly counsel. And I tell you, at the end of the day, you will never regret walking through that open door, and you will never regret taking advantage of that wonderful opportunity. Let's bow down our head and close our eyes this evening. I really thank God for this great, great privilege that we have to listen to His word. You're here tonight, you're not right with God. You're not born again. You're the one I'm speaking to right now. God loves you. Bible says He loves the entire world, that He gave His only begotten Son. And whosoever believes in Him will not perish, but have everlasting life. We don't want it to perish. We want it to have life in Jesus Christ. And if you're that man, you're that woman, I want to pray with you tonight. And I want to repeat this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you as a sinner because I'm not right with you, O God. I confess my sins and I pray that the blood of Jesus Christ that was shed on the cross of Calvary will wash my sins away. Make me a new person, Lord. Write my name in your book and give me the power to sin no more. Thank you, Lord, for the answer, O God. For in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. I really appreciate as many people that have repeated the prayer. And I really appreciate those of you that have just given your life to Jesus Christ. We love you. And we're going to be praying for you. A few things that I wanted to do is to cultivate the habit of speaking to God. It's called prayer. You speak to God. Read the word of God, which is the Bible. And also, find a living church you can attend. You can always view us on our YouTube channel. And when the church is allowed to start worshiping in their building, you can also fellowship with us at number 94 Biadene Ages Avenue, Ikeja. We'd love to see you, and we'd love to see you living for God. Tonight we're going to pray. Okay, I want to take time to speak to God. I know many of us, we've come across opportunities that we're not really sure, is it from God? Or is it not from God? And many believers have entered through doors that have caused them pains. And we don't want a repeat of that. We don't want to live our lives in pains as believers because we went through an open door or took an advantage of an opportunity we ought not to have done. But so tonight, God is willing to forgive us and God is willing to help us, that every advantage that comes before us and is from Him will truly be for our benefit. Let's pray. Father in heaven, Lord God, I come before you, God. Lord, I pray that you will help your children tonight, oh God, Lord, I pray them. Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you, Lord, for this evening, oh God. Lord, I bless you, holy name, God, for, Lord, teaching us, helping us, reminding us, Lord, again, Lord, concerning steps to take, Lord, when it comes to opportunities and open doors. Lord, I pray that you will help us, God. These words will be rooted in our hearts, oh God, and we'll be doers, God. In Jesus' name we're praying. Amen. I really appreciate everyone that listened tonight and also watched on our YouTube channel. God bless you. And also, before we go, it's part of our worship service to give to God our tithe and our offering. So I will encourage you to be generous to God this evening. You will see the account number immediately after this message, and you could give your tithe and your offering to God. God bless you as you do that. See you next week. Amen.